In the last video, the Most High led me to speak about how the prophecies that are recorded in His Word are for 30-day months. I'll expand on this in this video. These prophecies testify that His months are supposed to be 30 days in length, and that they always were before He altered them. He altered the rotations of the luminaries during the days of King Hezekiah. He did so as part of His setting up His time of judgment that He told us that He is going to send upon Israel's descendants at the time of the end. And as part of His judgment, now that we have come to the time of the end, He has restored His 30-day months. He has done so through the testimony of His Word. The reason that His Word gives to us for why He altered His months in the first place was because Hezekiah did not believe His Word that He spoke to him through His servant Isaiah. In the last video, He led me to make a reference to His end-time prophecies that He gave to us through His servant Daniel. In the last chapter of Daniel, we are told of three different periods of time for the last days. One of them is for a time, a dual time, and a half a time. This is a prophecy that is attached to the man that would be clothed in linen and sit to us in the last days. Daniel was told in chapter 12, "Then I, Daniel, looked and beheld, there stood two others, one on this side of the bank of the river and one on the other side of the bank of the river. And I said to the man that was clothed in linen that was above the waters of the river, how long will it be to the end of these wonders?" Above the waters of the river is a prophetic reference to the one that the Most High would send to announce the turning of the baptism waters into His only begotten Son's shed blood. Daniel wanted to know when these things would be. In verse 4 and in verse 9 of this prophecy here in chapter 12, Daniel is told that these things would be sealed until the time of the end. But even though the time of these things was sealed, Yahweh went on to answer him with a prophecy that is for the time of the end of man's self-rule. In verse 7, "The man clothed in linen that was above the waters of the river held up his right hand and his left hand unto heaven, and I heard him swear by him that lives forever that his hand will end the scattering of his set-apart people at an appointed time and a dual appointed time and a half," referring to a half of appointed time, "and all of these things will come to an end." Precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line, here a little, there a little, His Word testifies that this is a prophetic reference to the 3 1/2 year testimony of the one that would be clothed in linen and sent at the time of the end to restore all things. And the revelations of our Messiah testify that these 3 1/2 years cover a span of 42 months. And His revelations also testify that these 42 months are 1260 days. Therefore, each of these 42 months has 30 days in them. In lieu of this, if you cannot see that the months are supposed to have 30 days in them, and that they were altered, and that they would be restored at the time of the end, you are quite obstinate indeed. These 1260 days also parallel another tier of this prophecy that pertains to different 1260 day periods. These periods were discussed in one of the earlier videos that Yahweh led me to produce. The second period of time found in Yahweh's end time prophecy that He gave to us through His servant Daniel testifies to His 30-day months as well. It is for 1290 days. 1290 days is 43 30-day months. Yahweh's third period of time is for in this prophecy is for 1335 days. This is 44 and one half 30-day months. These periods of times are spoken in other videos as well. For the last several videos, at the end of them, Yahweh has led me to repeat the sounding of the shofars that He led me to sound last year. Until He leads me to do differently, I will continue to sound them at the end of these videos. He led me to sound the shofars last year for 7 days to represent Israel's 7-day march around Jericho. Since there were 7 laps on day 7, there were 13 laps total. Day 1 of the sounding of the shofars was on the first day of the 10th month on His restored calendar last year. This was on December 19th on Satan's calendar. This was 390 days prior to the fast approaching first day of the 11th month. 390 days is 13 30-day months. After 40 years in the wilderness, on the first day of the 11th month, Yahweh's servant Moses spoke to the children of Israel all that Yahweh had commanded them to do. This is recorded in Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 3. "And it came to pass in the 40th year, on the first day of the 11th month, that Moses spoke to the children of Israel all that Yahweh commanded unto them." I'll expand on a couple of parallels to the 40th year in a bit. The 13 laps around Jericho that were accomplished in 7 days represent the 13 tribes of Israel. The tribe of Joseph was divided into the tribes of Ephraim and Manasseh. The reason why the tribe of Dan is not mentioned in the revelations of our Messiah is because they are not part of Yahweh's first fruits. These 13 laps also represent the 13 colonies that were formed here in America when he scattered some of Israel's descendants into this land. Yahweh gave his end time Son of Man instructions to lie on my left side for the 390 days or for 30 day periods. These instructions are found in Ezekiel chapter 4. Son of man, lie upon your left side and put the iniquity of the house of Israel upon it. You shall lift up their iniquity for the number of days that you lie upon it, because I have given to you the years of their iniquity according to the number of the days. For 390 days you shall lift up the iniquity of the house of Israel. During these 390 days, when I have laid on my left side, I have faced the east. Then Yahweh instructions tell me to, and when you have finish them, lie again on your right side, and you shall lift up the iniquity of the house of Judah for 40 days. I have given to you each day for a year. Thus you shall make ready for the siege of Jerusalem before your face, and your arm will be uncovered. Thus you shall prophesy against them. During these 40 days that we are now in, when I have laid on my right side, I have faced the west. These two periods of time total 430 days, each day for a year. And in Exodus 12, verse 40, we are told the habitation of the children of Israel who dwelt in Egypt was for 430 years. Do you think that it is a coincidence that the first English colony in North America was founded 430 years ago? Humphrey Gilbert took possession of the harbor of St. John and founded it in August of 1583. I can assure you that it being named St. John is not a coincidence either. I spoke about this more in the 430 years in America and the second Exodus video. I'll put the link to this video in the video description box below. August 16th of this past year on Satan's calendar was the first day of the sixth month on the Most High's restored calendar. It was on the first day of the sixth month that the Most High gave the first of his four end time prophecies to his servant Haggai. The first three of these four prophecies are for Zerubbabel and Yeshua. The fourth one is for Zerubbabel. I'll read you the fourth one in a bit. On the first day of the sixth month, we were 150 days or 5 30-day periods from the first day of the 11th month. On this day, we were also 157 days from January 20th or the eighth day of the 11th month. Yeshua told us that it would be as it was in the days of Noah at the time of the end. The sheer volume of parallels that the Most High has woven into his end time timeline to as it was in the days of Noah is phenomenal. It was 157 days from when Yahweh started loading the ark until he recorded that he remembered Noah. The last 40 of these 430 days will end on the first day of the 11th month on Yahweh's restored calendar. Do you think that after 40 years in the wilderness on the first day of the 11th month that Yahweh's servant Moses spoke to the children of Israel all that Yahweh commanded him to do is a coincidence? I'll put that verse back up on the screen. I can assure you that all of these parallels are not coincidences. Another parallel to these 40 years in the wilderness will be the 40 years of Yahweh's Ezekiel chapter 29 prophecy. This prophecy testifies that the United States will lay desolate for 40 years after the 7 weeks of burying the dead. These 40 years will follow the 7 weeks of burying the dead will follow the eighth day of the 11th month, which will be on January 20th. Then the 40 years will follow that. Yahweh told us that his end time witness would be sent to you in the manner of similitudes of that which was manifested to our ancestors through his servants, the prophets. For those of you who are new to the videos on this site, or for those of you who cannot seem to get this simple reality through your thick heads, I'll put the verse where it says this back up on the screen in Hosea chapter 12. I, Yahweh Elohim, brought you out from the land of Egypt. Yet again, I will make you to dwell in tents in the day of my appointed time. I have spoken through my prophets, and I will multiply my revelations through similitudes through the hand of my prophets. Notice the parallel there with the day of my appointed time in reference to Daniel's appointed time, a dual appointed times and a half appointed time. Yahweh keeps leading me to hammer these verses in these videos because of the incredible volume of similitudes to his prophecies that he has woven into the past nearly 3.5 years now. His doing so in this manner has established his witness against you through the testimony of his word. In the last video, he led me to mention that when he altered the rotations of the luminary because Hezekiah did not believe his word that he spoke through his servant Isaiah, that his doing so created a 19-year lunar cycle. He orchestrated it this way, 1 year for each of his servant David's 19 sons that came from his wives. Yahweh's word and his end time timeline weave in several similitudes to that which concerns his servant David. He has done so to reflect the importance of having a heart like his servant David's heart. The title of this video is I will shake heaven and the earth. I said that I would read to you the fourth end time prophecy that he gave to us through his servant Haggai. Haggai chapter 2, speak to Zerubbabel, the head of Judah, saying, I will shake the heavens and the earth. I will overthrow the thrones of kingdoms, and I will destroy the power of the kingdoms of the heathen. And I will overthrow their chariots and those that ride in them, and their horses and their riders will be cast down, each man by his brethren's sword. In that day, saith Yahweh of hosts, I will bring Zerubbabel my servant, the son of Shealtiel, saith Yahweh, and I will put upon him a signature ring, because I have chosen him, saith Yahweh of hosts. This is a reality that is soon going to be manifested upon you if you do not return to the Most High through that which he has restored. His word declares that he was going to put his signet ring on this one servant at the time of the end. His word testifies that he would restore all things through this one servant. His word testifies that these all things would include his 30-day months, therefore the correct timing of his Sabbath and the rest of his appointed times. His word testifies that he was not going to alter the rotations of the luminaries back until after the great and fearful day of his wrath. His only begotten son told us that no sign would be given to the wicked and adulterous generation that requires a physical sign except for the sign of the prophet Jonas. This sign testifies to the restoration of the 30-day month. And the Most High has woven several similitudes of that which his prophet spoke into his end time witness that backed this restoration up as well. His word testifies that his wrath would not be in the 3 1/2 year testimony that he has sent me with, yet that it will accompany it. He is going to shake the heavens and the earth, and he is going to do so soon. Turn from your rebellion to the Most High and return to him through that which he has restored, and flee to the hills and to the mountains, so that you will not be a partaker of his hot indignation. The signet ring that Yahweh Elohim has placed upon my hand is summed up in Isaiah chapter 55 verse 11. The signature ring that he has placed upon my hand is why he gave us his word. He sent his word down from his throne in order to teach us to become as he is. We become as he is when we walk with him in his word and do so in agreement with his righteousness that his word testifies to. In the verses leading up to verse 11, he tells us that our thoughts are not as his thoughts are, and our ways are not as his way is. He goes on to tell us that he sends the rain and the snow down from heaven, and that before these waters return to him, they cause the plants to bud and to bring forth so that they give seed to the sower and bread for us to eat. The water that he sends from heaven provides what we need for life. Then he tells us in Isaiah 55:11, my word that proceeds forth out of my mouth is in the same manner. In the same manner means that his word comes down from heaven in order to nourish us and to give us eternal life. His word is the unleavened bread that he sent down from heaven to teach us his thoughts and his way. He goes on, my word will not return to me void. It will accomplish that which I purpose, and it will prosper in that which I sent it to do. He sent his word to us in order to build his eternal family through it. He sent it to teach us his righteous thoughts and his righteousness. He did so because two cannot walk together in harmony unless they are in agreement with each other.